First of all, my due respect to all the dignitaries over here, as well as to the organizer, especially to Ranjit to accommodate me here, because I have a class, and because of that, I asked him to just to change the time period for me to give the talk. Okay, so without any wasting time, because I know that the students are waiting for their paper presentation, they are eager to do that. So I don't want to make the hurdle between those kind of things. So I'm going to share my slides and then start. So with the permission of Dr. Ranjit.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, please.
Thank you. Okay, so today I'm going to talk not on the nanotoxicity and all, but I'm going to talk on something very interesting area, which is nowadays is emerging in the field of forensics, that is a food toxicovigilance. Need of the hours, the reason behind that why I'm selecting this particular topic, there's a certain incident happened in India last in decades. And another reason is that this is one of the area where we are more neglect the things. Means when we are going to the shopping for the products like for clothes and all these things, we are seeing the branded products and all the, what is the quality of these kind of things. But when we are selecting the food materials, sometimes we are neglecting the things. Okay, fine, this is this company, okay, fine. Without seeing the ingredients and all these things, we just purchase it. But last one decade, there's some incident happened. That is one of the reasons why my area of research is interest is moving towards the food toxicovigilance. And this is a need of the hour, which I'm going to explain over here. Okay, so let's start with the two things which is very common in forensic toxicology. One is the carbon monoxide poisoning, which is also called as a silent killer because it cannot be seen, it cannot be smelled, it cannot be heard. And second is the arsenic, which is present in water, which is also called as a sick poison. Chronic poisoning from the ancient times, these arsenic were used. But at the same time, another silent killer is in our vicinity, and that is basically the food materials. There's a lots of food materials. Junk food is nowadays is very common. Everyone is eating. And these junk foods is actually a silent killer. And they are causing the different kind of diseases. Because we feel that nowadays we are suffering from different kind of diseases. Currently we are suffering, we are facing a one epidemic, that is the corona. Apart from that, the cancer and many things has happened. So we are trying to think that earlier people also eating the same kind of thing, but they are not suffering from these kind of diseases. But nowadays, every five or six people from one people is suffering from different kind of diseases. And those diseases is sometimes is caused because of our food habits. This is another silent killer everyone is taking. This is a sugar cubes. Refined sugar is also a silent killer. Most, at least in the Gujarat, most of the people are suffering from the diabetes. And diabetes is occur because of the more amount of glucose in our blood. So now that is the reason why I'm selecting this particular topic as on toxic vigilance. How our food is basically adulterated and how we can do for checking and all these things. So food poisoning, this is our first thing in common our mind when our food is not good and we are eating, consume those kind of foods. And at that time, the food poisoning is a sign and symptom of that. Which you can say that is a screening kind of thing where the people is suffering. But these food poisoning, when you are continuously taking these kind of food materials, then these food poisoning is converted to the dangerous diseases. And they causing, these food poisoning may occur, there's a different symptoms like nausea, diarrhea, abdominal cramps, headache, fever, dizziness, and all these things. But these food poisoning, when continues for the long time, it is converted to the different kind of diseases. And if you see here, this is one stats which I got from the internet, and where it is mentioned that before the COVID outbreak, which is also the epidemic diseases, Before it, food poisoning is the second highest epidemic disease which is occurring in India. But these kind of epidemic, we are taking very, very not seriously, because food poisoning normally is a life threatening at the initial stage. But in the later stage, when the food poisoning is basically a serious concern, then it may cause a different kind of other diseases. It may also lead to the cancer and all. Then it is become a life threatening. So the question is that what is how these food materials are contaminated? Because no one is intentionally do these kind of things, but yes, our raw materials may be contaminated at the time of when they are grown into the agriculture field. With the help of when we are using the pesticides and all these things, maybe pesticide is not fully removed from the surface of the food material, then it is basically contaminated. Or the food handlers who's handling the food materials, either it is a farmer or the other food handlers, if their hands is not clean or they are not cleaning the things, then also the food is contaminated. Our packaging packed food materials, which is having the lots of preservatives and other chemical as ingredients for keeping it more long time storage, that's why they are using. At that time also the food is get contaminated. Apart from that, the animals, birds, swine flu, bird flu, many things is happening in our surrounding last 10 years. Insects, rodents is also play an important role as of who's causing the food as a food contaminant. The sewage, soil, water even is also having the lots of nowadays the heavy metals and all, which is basically work as a contaminant into the food. Now the question is that what is the method of prevention of these from the food poisoning? So first is basically to clean the food materials. Whenever you bought the food materials from the market, just to clean properly. Nowadays, definitely at least last 1.5 years, once the corona outbreak came, everyone is doing at least. Apart from that, there is some food material which should be separate out. They cannot be keep it together. That is also the reason sometimes they are causing the poisoning to each other. Then cooking, what optimum temperature we have to cook, because overcooked food product or less cooked food product is also causing the food poisoning. Then the chilling temperature. Many times whatever we have brought from the market, we can put it into the fridge. But we have to see that what is the storage temperature is mentioned on the particular packaging materials, whether it is on 4 degrees, it is on 0 degrees, or it is on room temperature. So we have to take care of these, because it is also more chilling is also causing the food poisoning. Similarly, the throw away, how we are throwing the things from as a waste material. And obviously we have to think about these bacteria which is present on the surface of the kitchen, surface of the floor of the kitchen, everywhere it is present. So we have to clean each and everything. The question is that how the forensic play an important role. So forensic play an important role in as a checking, or you can say the vigilance point of view. The main purpose is food safety, and that food safety is done with the help of the food checking. The question is that food checking is done by the FSSI, which is a regulating agency in India. Yes, they are checking, but they are checking only for the branded material, not for the street food material and all these things. Sometimes they are checking the street food material suddenly, but not every time. And it is also difficult for them to check each and every food product every day. So that is the reason why we need to develop a methods with the help of that we can check these kind of what kind of contaminants are present, because until we don't know the contaminants, what kind of things we are going to detect. So first thing is that the biological contaminants, where the bacteria, virus, and mold, seeds, fungi, everyone seeing these kind of things in their food materials, which is microscopic in nature, but when they are forming the colonies, it is visible by the anadidizer also. So these are the biological contaminants. Second is the physical contaminant. Sometimes these physical contaminants also present in our foods, like fingernails, screws, nuts, bolts, bottle tapes, tops, and the plastics, the hair, eyelashes, mouse poo, coins, bits of metals. Many things if you take it from the market, you can observe it. Sometimes these kind of things is also present in our food materials. Dead flies, dead mice, jewelries, and these kind of things is having sometimes these physical contaminants is having the some metal compounds, and those metal compounds if reaches out, then they are causing the serious diseases. Third is some chemical contaminants, which is more abundantly used nowadays. They are using as a cleaning products they also serve as a chemical contaminants, which is we are using to clean our floor of the kitchen and all these things. They are also serve as a chemical contaminants. Then the chemical which is used into the garden, like pesticide, herbicides and all. Then the enzymes within the food materials, basically sometimes what will happen, these banana and other fruit material, it is ripen by the use of the different kind of chemical to enhancing the property of enzyme and activity of the enzyme. Because of that, before the time the fruit is get matured, so that they can go to the market and sell it. So that is the reason why these kind of things are used, and these chemical contaminants is more dangerous for all of us. So the question is that, is it any laws is there which is regulated by the FSSAI? Yes, there is a very strict laws which is governing by the FSSAI, and they mentioned that what kind of chemical you can use and which kind of chemical you cannot use in the food materials. But some food materials, like different kind of preservatives, they know that these are toxic in the nature, but they also know these things. Any material, any xenobiotic materials is toxic after certain dose. If you use below the certain dose, it is fine for that. So that is reason FSSAI and FDA is approved few different chemical and preservatives to use into the food material as a to serve for the long storage purposes. But once intentionally or unintentionally these food these chemical quantity is increased, then they are causing the different kind of diseases. And once these concentration is quantity is increased, that is causing the, that is called as adulterations. And when you are talking about the food adulteration, so food adulteration can be defined as a contaminants which is present into a food item, where they are adding some chemical which is harmful in nature after a certain dose, and they are remove the valuable substance from the particular food material. That is the definition of the food adulteration. And in these, now the question is that authenticity of the food becomes the questionable. When they are using these kind of material into the food, then definitely whether the food material is natural or it is basically synthesized, we don't know. So the synthetic food, if you are talking about the synthetic food where these kind of adulterants are used, they are become a question. Actually, these are the questions. And at that time point, the food material is also so questionable. Nowadays, if you're seeing the edible oils, 18% of edible oils are adulterated. Ghee, vanaspati, 11%. Milk and milk product. And you cannot avoid these kind of things from your kitchen. This is the essential things which is present in our kitchen. And these all are, if you see, the milk and milk product, 22% is basically adulterated. Cereal and pulses is 11 to 12% is adulterated. Sweets, which is you purchase from the sweet shop, that is 12% is adulterated. Spices is 16% is adulterated. And apart from that, atta, tea, coffee, beverages, chili and turmeric powder is also adulterated. The question is that what FSSAI is doing? FSSAI is doing their job. It is no any question. They are the branded food materials, if you check these kind of thing, adulteration level is very, very low. And they are not going to cause any harm to your body. But in India, only branded food product is not there. If branded food product is one, then 10 street food product is also present. And there is no any regulation of the street food products. And that is reason these kind of authenticity of the food materials become questionable. If you see the list of the food adulterants, which is commonly found, that is in the milk, that is unhygienic water is used, chalk powder, soap powder, hydrogen peroxide and urea is also used for this purpose, to giving the more white color and more frothing. They are using these kind of things. Then in black paper, the papaya seeds are used, oil, archimonde seeds are used, ghee, vegetable oil is mixed with the ghee, and animal body fats. Then chili powders, the brick powder and sawdust is used. Turmeric, the methionyl yellow is, which is a non-permitted colorant according to FDA, which is causing the cancer. They are also used into the turmeric product. So the adulteration leads to the basically the loss of the quality of the food materials, which is causing the different health issues. It is not causing the always the life-threatening diseases and all these things, but sometimes continuous food poisoning, and after the continuous food poisoning, the health is basically decreased, and that is not in the good shape. And after that, because you are suffering from that every time the food poisoning, then immune system is also compromised. And when the immune system is compromised, it may cause other kind of diseases, which is earlier not happened with you. And why these kind of food adulteration is done? Sometimes it is incidental, unintentional, but sometimes it is intentional. And why intentionally they use these kind of adulterations? The reason is just to get the economic gain. For example, why they are using the different coloring product into the food material? Just to giving the some attraction. Because of that, the consumer can attract towards those food materials and they can purchase it. So these are the reason why the food adulteration is enhancing exponentially in last 10 to 15 years in India. Now, what is the role of forensic here? So the role of forensic is here to detection of the food adulteration. Then again, the question is that these things are done by the regulating agency, but still sometimes regulating agencies are having some specific fixed protocol, and apart from that, they are not going to be used. So with the help of the forensic, they can use to detect if any kind of food adulterants, which is not tested into the FSSAI laboratories, then they can be checked into the food forensic laboratories. And after these some incident which is happened in 2015 or 16, just to recall all of you, the Maggi incident, which has happened with Nestle, where the Nestle product in India, which is prepared in Gorakhpur, it is having the lead content, and those lead content is crossed the permissible limit almost 16 times more present into that. After that, Indian FSSAI is sent to the notice to Nestle, which is a UK based company. First, they are not responding because Nestle is a multinational company and their product is everywhere. And only from the India, these type of complaint came. But once two or three notice goes to the Nestle and then government intervene in between these kind of things, then they realize and they come here and check it, what is the matter. And they found that protocol, what India is using to prepare the noodles is same, but the water which is used here, that is actually the contaminated. And because of those contaminated water, the Nestle product get contaminated and lead content is 16% is more as their permissible limit. So these kind of things, because why it is came into the picture, the reason is that the food inspector was a biochemist. He knows about the science, and when he saw the noodles over there, and he, there's some doubt he got from the water which is present over there. Then he sent it to the laboratory, to the Lucknow, Lucknow to Calcutta. Two times he verified these kind of thing, and then they sent a notice to the Nestle regarding to this. So the question is that the authenticity is in question. So that's why these in the forensic, the food forensic branch is emerged. And the role of the food forensic branch is to just to check the authenticity and to detect the traceability of the food adulterants material which is present into the food products. This food, why the food forensic is important? The reason is that food is directly related to the human health. And human health means it is directly related to the life of the humans. So that is reason why the food forensic is an essential requirement in India right now. Food forensic is used for the consumer safety. It is used for the industry liability and the reputations, regulatory requirements, and also for the public relation and the product perceptions. So right now only FSSI is working in this direction. If the forensic laboratories also start to work in this particular direction, then it can be helpful for the FSSI laboratories also, and even for the people of the India also. So this is the issue, Maggie issue, which has happened. That is the reason why I'm moving to research in this direction. And I already published on one paper where I checked the food adulteration in the turmeric powder, which is basically in the available in Ahmedabad market. And I found that there's a few street turmeric products is containing the methanol yellow, and that methanol yellow biological testing is still going on, and we found that it is causing the DNA damage. Means it is causing the DNA degradation, and if it is causing the DNA degradation, it may lead to the cause of cancer. So that is the one reason. Second is how can be the food adulteration is done, means how the manufacturer can use these kind of things. So basically, intentional addition is more risky as compared to the unintentional, because in case of unintentional, most of the time the concentration or amount of those food adulterants is very, very low, so that if you consume one or two times, there's no any harm. But if it is intentionally used, then it is a kind of a crime, because you are fortifying the food products. And how they are using those, they are basically the mixing the brick powder, because that is also in red color, with the red chili powder. They adding the color of to turmeric to enhance the color of the turmeric powder to attract the people. They adding the chalk powder into the sugar and salt to give the more whiteness. They are adding the terminant seeds into the coffee to mixing of that. So they use those other coffee grains into other packet. Then water in honey. Recently, this case is also came in 2021, where the 77% of honey product which is selling in the Indian market is basically adulterated. Then using the different chemicals such as the calcium carbide, ethaphone, oxytocin in the food product for the ripening of the food materials, then vegetable for the artificial ripening and all. So these kind of materials which is used for ripening of vegetable or the food products, it is causing the serious diseases apart from the food poisoning. That is the main concern over here. Now the question is that what are the methods which are currently used for detection of the adulterations? So first method, which is most commonly used in our FSSI food laboratories, which is biochemical testing. They are testing like methanol yellow is there. So methanol yellow is testing with the help of the SCL, concentrated SCL. And with the help of the concentrated SCL, if the methanol yellow is present, then a pink color of solution is coming. Okay, so these kind of colorimetric test is performed into the food laboratories. And apart from that, they are using the HPLC as a chromatography. If the mixing of the sample, mixing of the adulterants are present, into the food product, then with the help of the HPLC, they can try to detect it. Then FTIR is currently used nowadays because this is a non-destructive method, which is one of the reasons why it is used. NMR is used for if the materials are organic in nature, and mixing there's a lots of mixing of materials is there, then they are using the NMR. Apart from that, the two different other methods are nowadays used. If the biological contaminants is present in your food material, then with the help of the quantitative PCR, which is also called as real-time PCR, with the help of that you can identify. Or develop devices, which is point of care devices, where you can use a different kind of bioreceptors and transducer. With the help of that, instant result will be observed. So you can screen the food materials maybe on field. Right now, there's only few methods is available where the on-field detection of these food adulteration is possible. Otherwise, all the methods which is nowadays is used, they are chemical based methods. So what this is one of the example how the olive oil is basically adulterated and how it is going to be checked. So we know that the olive oil is high in demand, but at the same time it is high in cost. So the fraudulent people, what they did, they adulterated the olive oil in the two ways. One is using the low quality values of olive oils or the low quality of the vegetable oils. These are two ways. If low quality of olive oil is present, then it is very difficult to detect it, because in the olive oil, if the low quality olive oil is mixed, the content is same but the quality is bad. So in those conditions, the health and safety issue is there, but here there is no any chance to detect. But if the low quality of vegetable oils is used, then there's a different methods like vibrational spectroscopy, mass spectroscopy, chromatographic techniques, thermal analysis, and other techniques like nanomaterials you can use for the biosensor development and all. It can help to detect these kind of low quality of vegetable oils into the your extra virgin olive oil. So in this way, you can detect it and it can satisfy the consumer also. These are some list of adulterants which is used into the different food materials, and these are different diseases which is caused, like edible oils. The argemone is as used as an adulterant, and skin infection and heart disease is caused. In the milk, urea and melamine is used, where the renal blockage and kidney failures may be possible. In the salt, they are using the white powder and all, sugar, chalk powder, ghee. In the sweet potato and vanaspati is present, which is causing the cancer. So there's a lots of food items is there, and there's a list of adulterants is there, which is nowadays used in India, and it is causing the different kind of life-threatening diseases. If you see, many of diseases is basically leads to the cancer. If you see the ghee, here is a stomach disorder, here is a carcinogenic, here is also cancer. So this is one of the reason why the exponential growth of the cancer is increased in India, or not only in India, even in the globally. Reason is that the food materials is adulterated. Earlier, these food materials are pure. They are adulterated. Those adulteration limitations is very less. But nowadays, every second food materials might be adulterated. So this is the biggest concern here. And what kind of health problem which is causing due to the consumption of the adulterated foods? So there's a major and minor two kind of problem is possible. In the minor, it's fine. That is a fever, nausea, vomiting, cough, stomach pain, and diarrhea. But the major problem is the nerve damage. Nowadays, lots of people are suffering from the nervous disorders, paralysis, liver damage, degeneration of testes, cancer, bent knees. These are the reason every time we are trying to investigate what is the reason why nowadays people are suffering from these kind of diseases and all. But ultimately, we haven't checked it. What we are consuming, what kind of food products we are eating. If we are trying to elucidate or investigate in this particular direction, definitely half of those reasons of causing the disease may be solved. So the conclusion from my talk is here is first to say to the no to the adulterations. And second thing is that because I mentioned here, most of the people is become panic. All the food material is basically the adulterated and all what I am consuming. And maybe one day I'm suffering from any kind of disease. So keep calm and stop trying to using those kind of food adulterated product. Just to check the ingredients, what kind of ingredients is present. You check the ingredients, what kind of health effect may cause because of if you consume those kind of food materials. So if you get aware, public get aware, everyone get aware, then definitely one day these food adulterations can be stopped in our Indian market. So the food adulteration is no doubt there's a major problem, and we are trying to overcome these issues with the developing the new methods, with the more stringent our laws, strong vigilance and awareness, which is most important to require. And that is the reason why I'm mentioning to this is a need of the hour to develop the inexpensive methods to. Because whatever the method is available, it is only possible to check it into the laboratory, not into the home. Why not we are trying to develop those kind of methods which we can do at the home? Means we purchase the food materials and immediately with the help of some instant kit, we can use it and we can check it whether our food product is safe or adulterated. So if we are able to do that, we are working in this particular direction, India is working in this direction. I hope very soon they can get with some solution for these food adulterations. So finally, the food authenticity is a question which can be solved in the two different approach of the forensic. One is the investigative approach, means the product is in the market. You have to check it, those products, by the investigative approach, by the using the different chemical methods and other methods. And second approach is preventive approach. Basically, the food forensic is dealing with the preventive approach of forensic. Means before manufacturing, if we are trying to check those adulterants, then definitely we can reduce the chances of the adulterants in our product. And the food safety and healthy life become back in our India. So in this note, I'm going to stop my presentation. Thank you so much. Thank you everyone. And thank you organizing committee to giving me opportunity over here to present my thoughts on the food toxicovigilance.